हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 16, वाटर अ प्रेशियस रिसोर्स. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द वाटर साइकिल. लेट अस डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इन टुडेज क्लास, ग्राउंड वाटर एज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट सोर्स ऑफ वाटर. इफ वी डिग अ होल इन द ग्राउंड नियर अ वाटर बॉडी, वी मे फाइंड दैट द सॉइल इज मॉइस्ट. The moisture in the soil indicates the presence of water underground. If we dig deeper and deeper, we would reach a level where all the space between particles of soil and gaps between rocks are filled with water. The upper level of this layer is called the water table. The water table varies from place to place, and it may even change at a given place. The water table may be at a depth of less than a meter or maybe several meters below the ground. The water found below the water table is called groundwater. What is the source of this groundwater? The water that falls on the earth's surface slips inside the earth and gets accumulated, that is collected, in the cracks and gaps of the rocks present inside the earth. The water table is called the upper level of the layer of water present beneath the earth. The water table can vary from one place to another. Here in figure 16.7, we are given the groundwater and the water table. The water table is called the upper level of the layer of water present beneath the earth. Earth ke beneath, yani ki niche. Under the ground, the water that is present, uska jo upper level hai, us layer ko hum bolte hain water table, as it is shown over here. The water table can vary from one place to another. The water that is present beneath the water table of a place is called groundwater. As you can see here, this is the groundwater. This is the water table, and over here you can see the groundwater. This water gets accumulated inside the earth because of different resources, such as rainwater that falls on the earth slips inside the ground. Water in the rivers, lakes and ponds often slips into the earth and gets accumulated as groundwater. So we can say that these are the sources of the groundwater. The rainwater and the water from other sources such as rivers and ponds seeps through the soil and fills the empty spaces and cracks deep below the ground. The process of seeping of water into the ground is called infiltration. The groundwater thus gets recharged by this process. At places, the groundwater is stored between layers of hard rock below the water table. This is known as aquifer. Water in the aquifers can be easily pumped out with the help of tube wells or hand pumps. Firstly, let us discuss about infiltration, the process by which water accumulates into the ground by traveling through the soil pores is called infiltration. As the water falls back on the earth, it travels along the surface and gets accumulated at different places like lakes, rivers, seas, oceans, and under the ground. That's how the amount of water is regulated on the earth. Next, let us discuss about aquifer. The underground layer of rocks that contain water present between the cracks and empty spaces is called aquifer. This water that is present in the aquifer can be pumped out using tube wells or hand pumps. Groundwater is generally obtained by digging wells using hand pumps and electric pumps. Have you ever been to a site where construction work is going on? Where do the workers get water for construction? Maybe you have seen boring being done at such sites to reach the water table. Enquire from the people working there how deep they have to dig. Can we keep on drawing water from under the ground? How will it affect the water table? Here we are asked some questions. If you have ever seen a site where construction work is going on, you must be aware that they get water for construction with the help of bore wells. Now, here we are given a word boring, boring being done. What is boring? Here, boring means to make a hole in the ground with a tool or by digging. Next time you have a chance, you could ask the people working in the construction site about how deep they have to dig in order to get water. Can we keep on drawing water from under the ground? How will it affect the water table? Here we are asked that, can we keep on drawing water from under the ground? And also we are asked that, how will this affect the water table? To get the answers to this question, let us discuss the next topic, depletion of water table. Water drawn from under the ground gets restored by seepage of rainwater. The water table does not affect as long as we draw as much water as is replenished by natural processes. However, water table may go down if the water is not sufficiently replenished. This may happen due to many reasons: increase in population, industrial and agricultural activities are some common factors affecting water table. Scanty rainfall is another factor that may deplete the water table. Yet another factor affecting water table could be deforestation and decrease in the effective area for seepage of water. The water we take from the ground gets restored, that is, refilled, when water seeps into the ground after rain. The water table of a place may decrease if we keep on taking out more water than what is getting replenished due to rainfall. There are several factors that can cause water table depletion. These include increase in population, industrial and agricultural activities. Scanty rainfall is another factor. Now, what is the meaning of scanty rainfall? Scanty means insufficient or less. The term scanty rainfall means very less or low rainfall. Scanty rainfall results in dry, arid conditions as seen in the deserts. The opposite of scanty rainfall is heavy rainfall. The other factors include deforestation and decrease in the effective area for seepage of water. Water seepage ke liye jo area hai wo decrease hota hai. Kaise decrease hota hai? That we will learn in the next paragraph, increasing population. Increasing population creates demand for construction of houses, shops, offices, roads and pavements. This decreases the open areas like parks and playgrounds. This in turn decreases the seepage of rainwater into the ground. What could be the consequence? Recall that a pakka floor does not allow water to seep in easily, while in a grass lawn, water seeps through in no time. So the first factor that we are going to discuss that affects the depletion of water table is increasing population. As the population of a region increases, the demand of fresh water also rises sharply. This means more water is being required. Also, increasing population demands more space, which leads to the construction of more houses, shops, industries, buildings, and roads. The number of places like parks, grounds, or forests decreases. All this reduces the possibility of rainwater getting into the soil particles because the concrete floors and roads do not allow seepage of water. This means that an increased demand and use of groundwater as compared to the replenishment of the water table. यानी कि जितना पानी ग्राउंड वाटर में स्टोर हो रहा है उसकी कंपैरिजन में वी आर यूजिंग मोर वाटर. सो दैट इज़ व्हाट दिस मींस, डिक्रीज इन इफेक्टिव एरिया फॉर सीपेज. क्योंकि कंस्ट्रक्शन बढ़ रहा है सो देर आर मोर कॉन्क्रीट फ्लोर्स दैन लॉन्स एंड पार्क्स. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस देर इज़ लेस सीपेज ऑफ वाटर एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस देर इज़ लेस रिप्लेनिशमेंट ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर. This results in the depletion of water table of that region. Moreover, a huge amount of water is required for construction work. Often, groundwater is used for this purpose. So, on the one hand, we are consuming more groundwater, and on the other, we are allowing lesser water to seep into the ground. This results in the depletion of water table. In fact, the water table in some parts of many cities has gone down to alarmingly low levels. This is just what we discussed over here. Construction jo hai wo zyada ho raha hai and we need groundwater for construction work, just like we discussed earlier. And what happens due to construction is, after construction, the number of concrete floors increases. That is, there is less area, less effective area for water to seep into the ground. If water ground mein seep nahi hoga, then there will be decreased groundwater level. Now, because of this, we are using more groundwater and we are allowing less water to seep into the ground. So because of all these reasons, there is depletion of water table. Water table jo hai wo less ho raha hai. So in many parts of the cities, the water table has gone down to very low levels. Increasing industries. Water is used by all the industries. Almost everything that we use needs water somewhere in its production process. The number of industries is increasing continuously. Water used by most of the industries is drawn from the ground. Every industry requires water in its production process. As the number of industries increases, more water is drawn from the ground. As a result of this, there is depletion of water table. Activity 16.4. Name some industries familiar to you. Make a list of the products obtained from these and used in our daily life. Discuss with your teacher and parents how the growing industrial activity is responsible for the depletion of water table. This activity requires you to make a list of industries that are familiar to you. You need to make a list of the products that are manufactured, that is obtained from these industries, and that you use in your daily life. Next, you need to discuss about how the rapid growth of industries and industrial activities are leading to the depletion of water table. Agricultural activities. A majority of farmers in India depend upon rains for irrigating their crops. Irrigation systems such as canals are there only in a few places. Even these systems may suffer from lack of water due to erratic rainfall. Therefore, farmers have to use groundwater for irrigation. Population pressure on agriculture forces increasing use of groundwater day by day. This results in depletion of water table. So next we are given agricultural activities. In case of no or low rainfall, farmers use groundwater to irrigate their land for agriculture. They are depending on rainfall in order to irrigate their crops. There are irrigation systems such as canals that are available for irrigating crops, but they are only present in a few places. This system also needs rainfall, and if there is no sufficient rainfall, then they may suffer because of this lack of water. Because of this reason, farmers have to use groundwater for irrigation. This results in the increasing use of groundwater. Also, the increasing population these days has led to increase in the agricultural activities, leading to increase in the use of groundwater day by day. Because of all these reasons, there is depletion of water table over the years.